They done let me in the door. They done gave your boy a chance, now the youngin' finna blow. It's a shame finna put the game in the figure four.
Like the most annoying. Continue call on mobile. Yes, it was on mobile. What was the problem with you taking it off mobile? Hello? I'm gonna keep these stickers. It'd be like the
What is email, Blair?
Who is this? Who's calling me now? Hold on, Gab. Hold on. Hello? Hello? Okay, you want me to back up some?
Can you sign me?
Yeah.
Have a good day, y'all.
You too, Jay.
Okay, y'all, let's send this to the broker real quick. Okay. I'm tripping. What'd I do with my fingers in right here? Send. Done. Do-do-do-do.
Oh, no. I'll be there too early.
Yo, yo. Sorry, I was doing, dropping off this the last load for yesterday. You know, I had three loads yesterday, and now I am. But this one doesn't pick up till 1. Yeah, I know. I actually got booked for 2 loads again. But the second load, I don't know why. Egypt in Illinois, because there's a part of Illinois that is close to me. But the Illinois where they were trying to get me to go to was like 8 hours away. And then I was going from Illinois to Kentucky. Exactly, I was going from Illinois to Kentucky and I got it. It was like 347 miles. I bid it $400. No, I didn't know I was 8 hours away. Because there's a part in Illinois where I'm close to. So I thought that was the part. I should have bid it $1,000. Cause I didn't, when I tell you it didn't take no time for them to reply. He was like, I bid at $975. He was like, what's the driver's name? What's the driver's contact number? And usually when they do that, it's just, there's like 2 reps that do that without actually having the load. So I'm like, man, this is that fucking rep that's always talking about, what's the driver's. So then he's like, what's your ETA to the pickup? And I'm like, did we get this load? He's like, yeah, we got this load. Then TQL called me. He's like, are you the driver that's in Jackson, Tennessee that's gonna pick up the load taken to Fort Myers? I was like, I don't know where I am, but I know I am in Tennessee and I'm an hour away from the pickup. He was like, okay, perfect. That's all I needed to hear. Thank you. I was like, okay. And then he's like, I'm gonna get back with your dispatcher. So TQL's making sure that that these drivers are where these dispatchers be saying that these drivers are. Because that's the third time TQL did that with a 5 Slow. Yeah, I got to pay for DAT anyways because, you know, I got to get my mom, my parents' dually truck out on the road. They keep, yeah, 180 for DAT. It ain't bad, ain't it? Yeah, it's 180. Yeah, $180. That's all that, that's what's 180 for his DAT. All I know is, well, you know, we can log in and see, but I know. I wish I could take a small load, like a local load, like a little quick little. This shit is small. This shit is one pallet and it weighs 260 pounds. Oh yeah, that's a good question. I don't know. It doesn't say. It just says 260 pounds. But you know what I need to do? I need to drive towards this place. And this is God giving me an opportunity to do an oil change. That's what it is. And that's what I'm going to take it as. So I need to go towards this area. And when I get closer to the area, I need to find a Dodge Chrysler Jeep.
At this time, me and my business partner talk. We like, oh, look, I'm gonna ask them what's going on. I asked them what was going on. I let them know that they are supposed to unload this load. And they said, we don't really have time right now. We have some other stuff we have to do, but we are going to have someone help you. So in the first beginning, no one was helping. I was doing it by myself. I'm gonna tell you, I'm gonna keep it real with you.
So this is the first load where I am completely lost. Apple Maps is wrong. Google Maps is wrong. So I had to come to the competitor's house, which is Nuclear Steel, to find where Skyline Steel is, where we're supposed to be picking up. Thank God we are picking up way above our schedule. But yeah. So we literally gotta go. Where's that building? Across the street over there. That's where we gotta go to. And the GPS was pointing us to somewhere way before it, to a cemetery. Let me raise this window, cause there's so much dust. check in CB channel 15. What?
This is me.
Hi, is this Skyline Steel?
Yes, it is.
Okay, I'm here for picking up an order that's going to Fort Myers.
Okay, do you have a reference number? It starts with a 33.
Yes. Give me 2 seconds.
Alrighty, and do you have a company name? Are you the white van?
No, I'm the chocolate girl in the Sprinter van.
No, that's so what I said. Are you in the white van?
Oh,
white van,
yeah.
I'm seeing right here.
Yeah, I heard white
van. Okay, and do you have a company name? Because I know you don't have anything on the side of the van.
Fox Carriers.
Okay, I heard carrier. What was the first part?
Fox. F-O-X.
Alrighty, ma'am. Well, I have you all checked in. And then what you're going to do now is drive past this guard shack and stay to the left-hand side of those barriers. You'll see a truck already down there.
Yeah.
So you'll just park right there. So. And then once they are ready to load you, they'll come to the road and get you, okay?
Okay, so park right behind that, what is that, cement truck right behind them?
Yes, behind that flatbed.
Okay. Perfect. Oh, it's a flatbed. Yeah, it is. And I have glasses. That's horrible. Okay, thank you so much.
No, you're fine. Yeah, thank you.
Bye-bye. Bye. While we wait here, guess what we gonna do? Edit some the YouTube vlog so we could drop tomorrow, cause we really not supposed to be here till 1 o'clock, and it's 11:56. Told me to come on, so I'm coming on. They gonna get us loaded up. I wasn't even able to open up my laptop. Okay, where you want me to go? I ain't put the seatbelt behind me. Thank you. just told me to sit right here. What the heck? Y'all, I don't know about this one. Y'all see what he's bringing me. Y'all are gonna laugh.
What's your pickup number?
It's 3-3-3-3-3-3. If I would have known, I would have moved and had it put up there.
I wouldn't have been able to get it in there that far. The mask won't fit in the back of the van. Picture of it, and then you'll go out past the guard shack, secure it, and walk back up to the window for your paperwork.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Like, oh god, look at, I know he not bringing me this. Yeah, he set that joint down and that joint shifted the van. Okay, so now we got to go back to the guard shack. It's hot. I could definitely fit a pallet through the door. Okay, yeah, I'll be right back. Yeah, it is, what time is it? It's 1:35. We are, what is it, 114 miles from our next gas stop. which we're at a half a tank. You know, when I'm riding at night, I don't want to go under 100 miles on my gas tank. Yeah, while we stopped in traffic, and this accident had to have just happened, or construction is just now getting out here, because it is 1:36. Gotta be construction. Police back there and all. A state trooper, I should say. Yep. And it's me. Like a goddamn sandwich between a whole bunch of semi trucks. You know, we delivering all y'all stuff that y'all be ordering, you know, getting to this money while y'all sleeping. But yeah, I ain't gonna keep talking and bore y'all. Let me get back to my Rodway. Cause y'all know that's what I'm jamming to. No accident and a semi truck flipped. Y'all can't even see. Damn, I hope that driver okay. Fuck the freight. I don't even think. Oh, it was one of the duty trucks. Dang, y'all. I hope he alright. Dang, man. Boy, this job is dangerous, y'all. Driving is cool, but it be like people driving tired. Other drivers driving like maniacs, not paying attention. Not giving trucks a break to move over because people coming onto the highway. Like, it'd be a lot of things that people don't pay attention to, G. I pray that that person is fine. It's just, you know, minor damage to, you know, materialistic stuff. And he all good, you know. But, yeah, let's keep riding and keep our eyes on this road. I'm gonna evaluate myself at the next rest stop, see if I'm too tired to get to the next one. But yeah, I am already in Florida. We stopping at Lake City, like the GPS was saying, we 113 miles. So yeah, I do an evaluation every time. I did have to stop and get Red Bull, but that Red Bull got me. But I just might call it a night, especially after seeing that. That's like a wake-up call. Like, shit, this freight don't gotta be there to the 5th. I'm just trying to drop it off early so I can keep my wheels rolling, you know, because, you know, I plan to be home for the 8th. So I wanted to get these last little couple days, make sure, you know, I execute every day to its full potential. But, yeah, y'all. I'll let y'all know what we decide when we get to the next rest stop, how I'm feeling, how far the next one is, and so forth, okay? Yeah, let me get ahead of my music. So y'all, as y'all can see, your girl has made it to the last love before the drop-off. Your girl is officially wide awake, okay? Listening to that Rodway got me motivated. Got me ready to go rock and roll. Y'all, this man. But y'all, we literally got 299 miles to go. We are going to make it there at 8:40 in the morning. That's 4 hours and 45 minutes. It is currently 3:57. Okay. And your girls are just going to rock it out. Screw it. Like, I'm up. It's going to be a minute before I fall asleep. I think there's like, if I do get tired, right, for the ones that are worried about me, we are currently at the top of Florida in Lake City. See, that's Florida. We at the top up here, and then we gotta go all the way down here. So there's the Loves right next door. There's two Loves on the way down, so I could stop on the two Loves on the way down if I really do get tired. But that Rahway got me rocking, and I'm already in the city, and this shit very familiar to me. So, you know, this is my backyard. So, I know we could thug it out for 299 more miles. Feel me? So, y'all, come on, let's rock and mother roll. Let's mother roll. I'm coming out. I want the world to know. That's what they was playing in the bathroom, y'all. So, you know, when you hear something like that, an old school jam, it just get kind of like hooked. So, skirt, skirt. Time to skirt, skirt. Time to skirt, skirt. And then I was going to stay here, y'all, but when I pulled up, it's been a couple kind of crazy looking people. So, I'm like, you know what? Let me just hit the road, Jack. And let me come up the moon, the moon, the moon, the moon. Let me ride out for the morning, 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 morning. Why is that truck saying I thought of that real dark gas station? Like, it be some truckers. You could tell they've been trucking their whole life, boy. Because ain't no way I'm going to sit at a dark old gas station when there's one gas station, the 19, and then there's the Loves, feel me, that you could sit at. And you ain't gotta, you know, ain't gotta do all that, you know? You ain't gotta be dolo solo in a dark parking lot. That just don't make no sense, feel me? So yeah, y'all. Yeah, so we made it on site. Yeah, they want me to go over that rock right there and go where you see that, where that yellow thing is. They want me to do all that, right? But yeah, I'm scared I'm gonna get stuck. Cause last time I was on white soft sand, I was in a Mustang and I got the Mustang stuck. Okay? I'm scared. But I guess we're gonna have to do it. These folks are gonna have to come dig me out with their big ass things, okay? Cause I ain't got time for this funny shit. Who's honking that horn at me? Go that way? Okay. If I get stuck, y'all gonna dig me out.
Yeah,
I got you, I got you. Right there, right there. Yeah. I felt the sand get soft. I don't trust this shit. I don't trust this shit. Is he waiting for me to open? I don't trust this shit. I don't trust this shit. Thank you. trying to get something off the pickup truck. Tiene así, tiene que hacer así. lo puede firmar o él no lo tiene que firmar. Está bien, toma. Tengo wipes.
Ok, ahorita me das una, ahorita me das una.
Oh.
Dame una wipe. ¿Es de alcohol, no? ¿Es de alcohol?
Sí.
Dame una. A ver si te firmo. Tenga las pinches manos bien sucias. Así. Ahí está bien, ahí está. Ahí está.
Después printea tu nombre. Printéalo también. Con el día que es hoy, el 4.
El 4, el 10, el 3, ahí estamos.
Gracias. Ten un buen día.
¿Te quedas chiquita, ok?
Gracias. Hey y'all, welcome back to the channel, y'all. I should have squeaking because I have my emergency brakes on. I should have started the vlog right when I was on my, once I caught the load. So y'all, we got a load from Curry because it is, y'all, hold on, correction, it is Thursday. Is it Thursday?
I don't know what day of the week it is.
It's Thursday, October 5th, y'all. Right, it is currently now 12:30 on the dot. And yeah, we are headed. We were sitting, so we woke up. We woke up about 6 and some change. Was on the low board all the way till about 7 and some change, 8. I told my partner, hey, can you jump on the low board while I go take a shower? So we've been on the low board since 7 o'clock in the morning all the way till 12. My partner is currently still on the low board. Due to the fact that we have not gotten a load off the load board, or Fox hasn't really been shooting out too many loads to us today, a Curry load did come in and is going 14 miles for $54, $56. I have a screenshot right here. So this is what we are hauling. There's a whole bunch of little things, right? So, watch us on our way, y'all. GPS says is exactly... Let me screenshot this for y'all. 28 minutes, and it's 14 minutes down the road. So, we're going to go ahead and start our day by doing this. This covers our gas that we put in. We put in like $63, so we're short a couple dollars. Look at the broom. So I have faith we will be out of here. Oh, yeah, I forgot to tell y'all. We are in Fort Myers. We had delivered. When did we deliver? Yesterday? Yeah, our last vlog should show us delivering yesterday, which was the 4th of October. A good old Wednesday. We were trying to get a load out, but just couldn't. Ooh, this is a dangerous road. Four lanes. I gotta cross over to the right. I don't like roads like this, y'all. Okay, yeah. Right there? My stuff fell.
lighting sound good.
Yeah. Some more days till we can relax.
Yep.
So y'all, we are done. Just that quick, and we met a pretty cool guy, Mr. Ted. Well, oh, my emergency brake. Now y'all, we are going to find, let's call it our partner. See what the low board looking like. It is 117. Trash that. Quail, trash that. I'm gonna find a McDonald's close by y'all and park it. That's what I'm gonna do for right now. So yeah, we decided to park up right here on the beach instead of going to the McDonald's. But I think I'm only going to be here for a couple minutes, y'all, because it is so hot. It is so hot. So, yeah, I'll keep y'all posted. There's really nothing on the load board, unfortunately. But this view is so nice. All right, yeah, I'll call y'all back on the next location. Good morning, y'all. It is Thursday. Damn, I'm an hour and 14 minutes away. Yeah, it is Thursday. No, it is Friday the 6th. And it is currently 7:20 in the morning. Bro, I need them to come on and open this gate. So, y'all, we are in... It is... Good morning, y'all. It is October 6th. It's Friday, October 6th, and it's 7:20 in the morning. Y'all, we got up at 5:55, right? Got up, straightened out everything, put up... Well, I still got to put up the bed. You see, it's not in its foil or whatever, in his bag. I got up, I got everything, you know, behind me, you know, folded the comforters and everything correctly, whatever. We have two loads today that we're going to be late to. Well, the second one we're going to be late to, because the first one really doesn't open until 7:30. So, the first one, it is a curry load. We got it off the curry app. It's 145 or $146. And we're literally going and dropping it off in Sarasota, Florida. Basically, St. Pete or whatever. So, we go to pick that up. So, we're going to pick up the curry one, right? Then, we got a load with our carrier picking up in North Venice, Florida. And dropping off in Sanford, Florida. Which is right by the crib. Or whatever, right? So we're gonna pick this one up. We're gonna pick this one up, curry load. Then we're gonna pick up our carrier's load. Then we're gonna drop off our curry load. Then we're gonna drop off our carrier's load. Okay, y'all. It's all en route, and the carrier's load is $275. The curry load is like $146 or $145. It doesn't tell me on the map, okay? So, come on. I really don't want to wait in this line, even though we have... The place doesn't open up till 7:30, and it's now 7:24. I thought if I could be here early, they'll load me up early, but no. And we're 64 miles away from the pickup. So we're gonna be 34 minutes late to the pickup. Not even that, we're gonna be like 40 something minutes late to the pickup. If this isn't open till 1:11. I will cancel out this load, y'all. It's $175. I don't like being late. And I'm already late. It ain't no telling how long they gonna take to load me up. Yeah, I'll call y'all back when I decide, because I'm about to, it's 7:26. I have no patience, y'all. It's 7:26. It'll be in a second. Let's get this show on the road. I'll be back, y'all. I'm going to call y'all back. See y'all. A little patience. That's all it takes. A little patience. Literally, I turned off the camera and they opened the gate. It's 7:28. 7:28 to be exact. I do the party of the century. I know where I need to go. I might need to go over there. Let me get out. Let me hurry up, y'all. Let me hurry up. Okay, y'all. I gotta cancel that order because it's 4 huge AC units. And I don't know if I'm gonna have enough space for what I have to pick up with our courier. And since our courier is a lot more money than this, it's $275. I would rather take that than this, all right? So now we're gonna be late for no apparent reason. Right.
Starting route to 1070 Technology Drive. Proceed to 4th Street, then turn right. Turn left onto Plaza Drive, then turn right onto Executive Circle. At the stop sign, turn right onto Executive Circle.
So now I gotta rush.
At the next stop sign, turn right.
30 minutes away by now if I wouldn't have just stopped. But it is what it is. It was really like my fault because I thought I was just picking up one AC unit, not 4. And the AC units are
at the stop sign, turn
big.
Right onto Veronica S. Shoemaker Boulevard. Then turn left onto Colonial Boulevard.
And then they're number one big and number two. I don't know.
At the light, turn left onto Colonial Boulevard.
With doing deliveries, y'all, is a lot of unknown factors because my carrier, their paperwork might say, it does say one box at 100 pounds is 48, 4x4x4, right? But it might not be 4x4x4. Feel me? 4 inches by 4 inches by 4 inches. Right? At 100 pounds, 4 inches. And it doesn't say inches or feet on here. So I don't know if the AC units and the 4x4x4 would have fit. So I don't want to take no chance. Canceled out the $140 with Curry. $145, $46, whatever it was. Unfortunately. And dang. Hopefully when we get to Sanford or whatever, we get like at least 2 curry loads that are like 75 on 75. That's all we could hope for. Dang, y'all. A rough start to the morning. I just knew I was going to make a $400 day today. I was just sure. But, y'all, that's why you guys to look. You got to look. I could call Fox and be like, you know, wooty woop. I could. Like, be like, I could call my courier company and be like, are they sure that this is what it is, you know? But with my courier company, I don't want to take a chance because they don't like us carrying 2 different loads at the same time. To be completely honest. So. We don't need to be cut off from them because they are really our bread and butter right now. And I'm trying to get a second van. So, I don't know if it's 4 inches or 4 feet. All I know is supposed to weigh 100 pounds, but child, these notes don't be accurate.
In 2.8 miles, turn left to merge onto I-75 North.
So we are now going to get there at 8:38. And my dispatcher wanted me there at 8 o'clock. So, enjoy the ride till I call y'all back later. Customer pickup right here. So I think I'm gonna need my ID. Okay, yeah. Be right back. Okay, yeah. So we gotta go to receiving, which is all the way around. Put my seatbelt on. Okay, y'all, so we are going to get loaded up with that box right there with the white paper. So while he goes and gets that box, I am going to go over here. What are they looking at in the water? Oh, that gator. Y'all see that gator? Hold on. There's a gator in the water. Oh, yeah, I'm not going to see it. Hold on, y'all. Let's get loaded. That's what's important.
Park the forklift first.
come in some. We are now loaded up and we are headed to Sanford. It is Sanford, Florida. It is 164 miles from where we currently are. So we are going to get there at 11. I think it's at 11:24. It's currently 9:10. So yeah, y'all. We have made it to the Sanford location and we are offloaded now to send in the rake, the BOL, and I'm going to sit till about 4 o'clock, see if I could get another load. I gotta go pee, so let's go to what the heck did she say? Y'all give me a second. Hey y'all, so y'all already know what time it is. It's time to count my pockets. So y'all, this was a whole week vlog. So this is a whole week from part one to part two, as y'all can see. And yes, it is not our regular chart. It's actually what I write down in pen and paper. The only thing that you guys will not see on here is the showers, because at this time and point, I was not paying for showers. My showers were actually free at the Loves. And as y'all can see, I did put on some of them my deadhead to pick up, but I did not calculate that to actually tell y'all if I was running at 90 cents a mile to a dollar a mile. I don't know at this time and point, but my newer vlogs will have that information. But anyways, another thing you guys will see is my monthly bills are down at the bottom right. Don't ask me why I did not incorporate them in my day-to-day when I was actually paying them. I don't know why. But anyways, here it goes. We made a total of $2,425.86. We spent on gas and food $401.93. We supposedly took home $2,023.93. Now, when we calculate what our monthly was that we took out this week, it was actually, what we actually took home, what we actually netted was $788.17. All right, y'all. So, the next vlog will not be an expediting vlog, y'all. It will actually be based on this Cleveland class trip that I took. So, I hope you guys enjoy that. Please don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe. Let me know what y'all want to see down below, what I should talk about in my next vlogs or whatever. But yeah, I'm gonna let y'all go. Toodles!